Hello there, my name is Tom and welcome to another episode with FM Campbell. Today we're going to be looking at the Pentagon Challenge, what it is, how to set it up, what the rules are, and basically what you have to do to complete the challenge essentially. I'm going to start off by how to set it up. It's very, very simple. You create a new game, basically a new career game, and this is the first screen you'll come to. So these are the countries that you need to load up. You can do it however you want. You can obviously add them and take them away, which I would probably do because obviously the game speed isn't fantastic with all of these leagues, with all of these countries. So for instance, you have the African the African countries, the Asian countries, European, North American, South American. Right, basically the rules of the Pentagon Challenge. You start unemployed, so you start with no club whatsoever, and you also start with previous experience or reputation as Sunday League footballer. And basically what you have to do is you have to win all five of the Continental Champions Leagues. So you have the African Champions League, the Asian Champions League, the European Champions League, which is the big one, the North American Champions League and the South American Champions Leagues. They're not all actually called Champions Leagues, but they're the equivalent of, in each continent. One massive rule: no cheating. You cannot cheat. There's just no point. Otherwise, you complete the game in absolutely no time, and it's just boring and pointless. And you will discover if you don't cheat, you will get into it a lot more. Which I will show you in a second. I've actually started one of these myself. I will go back to that in a second. So if we go on to the next screen, so they're the countries you tend to load the countries up that you think you'd want to manage in. I've heard people that have gone to Indonesia and India, and then when they go to Europe, they've been in the Czech Republic and things like that. I tend to not want to manage in them countries. And say when you come to South America, obviously North America, there's not much of a choice, or Africa. But you come to South America, I don't really want to go to any of the four. I don't want to go to Chile, Colombia, Peru, or Uruguay. So I tend to look at just Argentina, Brazil. But you also got to think about where you want to manage first. One of the rules, which is an optional rule, if we go to the next screen. There are a couple of optional rules. I'll go through them first. So you can add these rules in if you want to make it a little bit more of a challenge for yourself. So just to quickly, while I'm on this page, these are your leagues. Obviously, as you probably already know, you set them all to playable where you think you'd want to go. I do like Belgium teams. They do tend to have quite good youth prospects, so I tend to add view only on them. So I can't manage them, but they're available to view all the players and things like that. I don't use real fixtures, so fixtures are mixed up, so it's unpredictable. So you play your own game rather than copy a team in real life. And a disabled player and player attribute masking, because I don't really like it. You can make it harder for yourself and switch that on if you want, but it just means you've got to be scouting 24/7. And I tend to search for players with attributes via their attributes, so I always tick that. If we start the game, and I'll go through while that's setting it up. Other optional rules that you can add to make it a little bit harder for yourself if you wanted to. With your ingoings and outgoings and transfers, you can try and make a profit. You can obviously prove that with screenshots or whatever and so on and so forth. But yeah, if you can make a profit every season, which I this is one of the rules I've picked to do, then brilliant. So if you're signing free players, but then signing players on free, sorry, and then selling players for a grand, right up to 20 million if you wanted to, you can do that. Another rule, optional rule, which I've opted against, is to sign no foreigners. Most clubs outside of Europe have a limit on the amount of foreigners you can sign anyway. For instance, I'm actually in South Africa at the moment, and you can sign a maximum of 5 foreigners. So I've not done that one, but you can do that one if you want to. Another one is to be a member of the APLA, which is the Anti-Premier League Alliance, where you do not load England. This is known to be quite a legendary one. If you can do this, then fine. It basically means that you don't become a team in England, or you don't have any of their players available to you. Which, to be honest with you, when you're abroad anyway, in continents outside of Europe, most English players won't sign for you anyway. So that's kind of irrelevant when you're away. But when you're in Europe, obviously English players will move around. So if you want to be a member of the APLA, which is the Anti-Premier League Alliance, where you don't load England, you're more than welcome to. That's a rule that I didn't do. Whether I go to, I haven't decided yet if I go to England when I go over to Europe, I'm not sure. One rule which I have done, which is the no resigning rule. The only time you can change clubs or resign, you can only resign if you win the Champions League in that continent. That's the only time you can resign. But normally you apply for another job rather than resign, and you'd rather stay employed. It's like that common saying, you normally gain employment whilst you're employed. The only other way as well that you can change clubs is if you're sacked. Simple as that. One final thing that I've done, which I've seen dotted about as an actual rule, a rule that you have to do, but I've also seen it as an optional one. I've done a rule that you have to do, is you do the European continent, so you complete the European Champions League, you do that one last. So you have to go to South America, North America, Asia and Africa first, in whatever order you desire, but European has to be done last. And that is something that I have done. So here we go, this is my beautiful face, as you can see. We'll go back to this. So this is my name, I'm obviously Tom Campbell, that's my birthday. Obviously I can't have my date, the actual year, because it goes to 88. My nationality is English and Northern Irish, that's true. I have a Northern Irish father, or my dad. Place of birth, that's where I'm from. My favourite team is Man United. My favourite formation is 4-1-2-2-1, or it's either that or the 4-2-3-1 that I also like. 4-2-3-1 there, but we'll leave it as that for now. I've obviously already added a picture. So it's this bit here. So past playing experience has to be Sunday League footballer, and it has to start. That's one of the set in stone rules. So address me as Tom Campbell. So that's everything, I think. Mail. Okay, so we go next, you choose a team to manage, and up in the top right hand corner you click start unemployed, and it's that simple. You just click that and then you confirm. So I don't want to save the game for now. So now, as you can see, I am unemployed. First thing you want to do, go away, is you want to go to the job centre. It's the same as real life. You want to have all jobs, but you obviously don't want to go in Europe, so we'll turn European teams off. Then we want to do all jobs, and you want to turn all of these off, everything on there, but manager. So these are current available jobs. So this is basically how you search for the jobs. And then I just applied for all jobs. That's how I did it. Yes, and then you just continue. That team there, Jomo Cosmos, is the team I've taken in real life. So they receive all your applications, so we'll go through all of these and we'll continue. One thing you can also look at is you can look at the job security section, which is, I'll show you in a second, where you can find, in fact I'll do it now. So for instance, we've got Flamengo, unsuccessful, international in Brazil. Jomo Cosmos job unsuccessful. I got that in the last one. Yep, myself. So you get job interviews and you can attend the interview, but I won't go into that now. And they basically ask you all different questions and what you'd like to do and so on and so forth. And then jobs obviously always pop up, so you keep looking and applying for all. So I've applied for all of them already. You can also look at this job security. So these are positions around the world. Of jobs, obviously we don't really want national teams, so again you could turn all these off. I won't go through it now, but you can obviously see their job security. So for instance, there's clubs with managers that are under review, so they're reviewing whether they want to keep that manager. So I could go to Columbus if I wanted to. Because they're under review, I can declare interest in the job, and if they see me interested and they might want me, then they would obviously offer me an interview. So that's how it's done. So if I load, I don't want to save it, where are you, Pentagon Challenge. So if I load this up and I show you a basic idea of how far I've got. Right, so Jomo Cosmos, so this is the team. I'm currently in the Premiership and I am 24 games in out of 30 and I am 3 points behind top. I need to finish first or second, I think. Let's have a look. Continental qualification. Top two teams qualify for the African Champions League. So that's what I need to do. I need to finish in the top two. Ideally, I'd like to win it because financially it can support you. I've got a big squad. Obviously, out of your time, you get players that break in. This is one of my wonder kids that break in. A regen. I've had him since he was 16. One of the biggest things I've done is invest in the youth system. Another one is Mathabula. Again, another youth prospect. 4.5 star, 18 years old. Plays on the right wing and has got crossing and dribbling that are quite good. We'll look at the history of the club. So I took them here. They were bottom at the time and I managed to finish where the position that was. Let's see if it comes up. 6th. And then I won the league in my second season. They are really a top division team. So I won the league in the second season quite comfortably, I think. And then in my next season, I finished 7th. So I've completed 3 seasons. I'm in my 4th. Finished 7th in the top league. So in my entire career, I've won the Super 8 Cup, where it's the top 8 teams in the top division are in like an 8th through to a quarters, and through to a semis, and then through to the final, and I managed to win that. And then the South African FA Cup, I also managed to win. And the South African, that actually got me into the equivalent of the Europa League in Africa. And then I also won the First Division, as you know. And the equivalent of the First Division is the Confederations Cup. So I'm playing Dolphins, NGR, in the second leg. It finished 2-2 in the first leg. So yeah, going forward, you can see how that kind of works. Just to show you the profits stage as well. So it's quite a long video. Let's look at transfer history. So if we go back to the first season. So I signed all the players on free, so I didn't spend any money, but made a profit of 13.57k. In the next season, again, all on frees or loans, didn't spend any money, made 24.69k. And then I started to get youth players in where European clubs would want to buy them, which was quite fortunate. So again, all on frees, and I sold 65.8k. And it's actually this season where I've made quite a bit of money. So I sold all on frees again, haven't spent a penny my whole career, and I've already made 866k. And we've got a couple of months left of the season. One of my youth players, basically. He is quite good. I didn't really want to let him go, but I do have a couple of strikers all with the sort of same ability, and he was just valued quite high. So I think he was worth about 40k, and I managed to sell him for 600. And this guy I signed on a free, and then about 2 months later I sold for 275k. So that was quite good, because I had too many foreigners in the team. So I let them all go, so I've made quite a bit of profit for them. Still though, they are a club in debt. We've got new owners that aren't really willing to spend any money. So that's how it works. If you have any questions, then feel free to put stuff in the comment section below. Tell me about your stories. Tell me about your FM Pentagon Challenge stories. Feel free to go in as much detail as you want. Ask any questions at all. Don't forget to check out the Twitter page, which is at FM Campbell, where I'll be linking with you guys and interacting with you guys as much as I can. So that's about it. So please like, subscribe to the channel. My name is Tom, and thanks for watching.